We have this afternoon, we have a debate in the parliament, in the plenary session, on the situation in Iraq and Syria. And I'm going to tell you now in a nutshell what I'm going to say there, because I will have my speaking time. I say that taking into account situation in Iraq and Syria, we cannot go on without recognizing how negative influence Iran had all over the region. We have to recognize that Iranian regime has spread this influence over Iraq by penetrating their state structures, their administration, that it is also present in Syria via Assad's regime, and of course is present in Lebanon via Hezbollah. And quite recently it started to be also successful in Yemen. And that clearly indicates that Iran is trying to play the role of regional power and to try to rise its influence to the level that would be potentially dangerous for the whole world and for the stability and security. And frankly speaking, from a long-term strategic point of view, Iran even today is more serious security threat than so-called ISIS or Daesh, or however we can call that entity. And Iran, unfortunately, is acting in a very clever way, because it is trying to persuade the West that it could be an ally, its ally, in fighting ISIS, and is offering some kind of help. And I think it would be a great misjudgment and great misunderstanding and a great mistake from West to accept that weird offer, because the price the West would pay for that would be enormous. We can imagine that Iran would probably ask for some concessions concerning its nuclear program, and moreover, by accepting that, we would de facto help Iran to abolish or to cancel its biggest challenger in the region. So I think that we have to be firm, we have to think strategically as well. We have to declare that the West will make no alliance with Iran on that, that we are not ready to make any concessions to Iran on its nuclear program. And we also have to be ready to restrict politically Iranian influence over the region. And if we are to do that, we have to start in Iraq. Maliki is over, Abadi is there. But we have to make clear that what we expect now from this new administration is to make a clear cut from the past and to diminish, to reduce Iranian influence over the country. And the clearest example how they can prove that is that they will change their attitude, their behavior concerning Camp Liberty. If they change it, if they unblock the camp, if they let the people to take their medical care, and if they just will treat them normally and not like a prisoners, that would be the greatest sign of hope, and that would be also the biggest signal that things have already changed. So I think that we have now concentrate our forces, our political will vis-a-vis Iraq. We have to show them that we expect something from them, and we have to start in this particular point to start to reduce a very dangerous Iranian, to limit very dangerous Iranian influence over the region. So that's what I'm going to say in an hour from the plenary of the European Parliament. Thank you very much.